In this tutorial, I will show you how to buy and install WordPress on SiteGround step by step. I will show you which hosting plan you should use and the actual buying process. I will also show you how to correctly install WordPress on SiteGround to make sure that you don't click on the wrong things and make any mistakes. At the end of this video, I will also give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up SiteGround through my link below, and I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free. Now let's get started. Step one is to click on the link in the description below or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special SiteGround discount page where you will get the best discount SiteGround is currently offering. Full transparency, this is an affiliate link. I will receive a small commission while you get a special discount and my six-figure blogger course for free. So it can be a win-win situation for the both of us. And if you want to know how to get the course, stay tuned to the end of the video where I tell you how you can get this. So now we can see SiteGround offers three different plans: the Startup, Grow Big, and Grow Geek. The Startup plan only allows you to have one website with limited amount of space, and also the visitors per month is only capped at around 10,000 visits. But if you choose the higher plan, the Grow Big or Grow Geek, you're going to get an unlimited number of websites, and your web space and visitors per month will increase accordingly. But the biggest difference that the Grow Big and Grow Geek plan can offer you over the Startup plan is the speed boosting caching. This is SiteGround's special proprietary plugin where they provide you with three different levels of caching. So if you buy the Startup plan, you only get the first level, but if you buy the Grow Big or Grow Geek, you'll get all three levels. So unless you just have one local website, I would always suggest you start on the Grow Big plan. And once your business grows and gets enough visitors, then you can easily upgrade to the Go Geek plan with SiteGround support. So I myself have been with SiteGround for a couple of years and bought their Go Geek plan to start with as I migrated over from another hosting provider. And in this example, I will also purchase the Go Geek plan for you. But if you are stuck and not sure which hosting plan to choose with SiteGround, or if they are the right hosting provider for you, then check out this video where I do a full in-depth review of SiteGround and even test out their speed performance. Anyway, let's continue on our Go Geek plan and click Get Plan. This page will appear where you can choose your domain name. And as I recommend in all my videos, that you should buy your domain name from Namecheap, as it will only cost you $7 or $8 for a domain name, which includes the WhoisGuard for free, which will protect you from marketing agencies trying to spam you with their services or people trying to get leads. But if you choose to buy from SiteGround, it's gonna cost you $16 and you're gonna have to pay for your privacy protection separately. So you can see it's less than half price, and you can have all your domain name in the one convenient location with Namecheap. So overall, if you want the cheapest, go with Namecheap. And I have a video tutorial for you here, but if you're going to stick around with SiteGround for the long run and you just want the easiest and quickest option, then just buy a domain name with SiteGround now. And you would just type in your domain name here and check if it's available and click proceed. But in this case, I already have a domain name, so I'm gonna click I already have a domain. And I'll click on proceed. The next step is to fill out your email address, password, your personal information, and now come down further to the purchase information section. Now this is where it gets interesting. You can choose your data center from six different locations around the world. What I always recommend is to choose the location where most of your traffic comes from. So for example, if you have a local business in Australia or New Zealand, I would choose Australia as my data center. However, if you have a global website or your visitors are mostly from the USA, then I would pick USA. And in this example, that's what I'm going to do. And with the period, in this case, I would choose 12 months as they charge more for 24 months and for 36 months. SiteGround recently went through a new pricing plan update where they increased their current price for all their hosting plans. and now I would consider them to be more of a premium hosting provider. But the benefit is they really are one of the best performing hosting provider out there in the market. But if you don't have a big budget to spend, then I have a better recommendation for you at the end of the video. The next option you can choose is the SG site scanner, and this one we definitely don't need. So I'm going to skip that and click on confirm and click on pay now. So now when you come to the homepage, it will look like this. And to install our WordPress website, we would go to our websites tab and we would choose new website. And you will be presented with three different options. In most cases, you would choose an existing domain, which you registered with SiteGround, type it into this box and proceed to the next step. But I'm just going to select temporary domain for this example. And I'll click on continue. And now you can decide whether you want to start a new website or migrate a website. In this example, we will be starting a new website. But if you are migrating a website, I have another video that I'll put in the description for you to help you migrate your website for free. Anyway, I will continue and just select this. And now I'm going to choose WordPress. Now you need to choose your email address and password that you want to be connected to this website. I will do that now. Now click on continue. Now you get the option to choose whether you want to upgrade to the SG site scanner. And if you want to give SiteGround free money, then you can. But for me, I would never do that, and I'm not going to do it here. So I will just click on finish. Now it's going to take a couple of minutes to create your website, so just give it some time. Okay, so now that our WordPress has been installed, the next step is to go to manage site. And you can see here, their dashboard looks much different. SiteGround has updated their dashboard in 2019 and are no longer using cPanel. Personally, I really like this and I find it much easier to navigate through. And this is especially great for new beginners trying to start a website. Well, we still have another step to go, but I just wanted to quickly ask if you're getting value from my tutorial. If so, make sure to let me know by liking my video and hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss out on quality videos I release every week. Now, what we need to do is install our SSL certificate to secure our website. And this can be done with one click by going to security and click on SSL manager. Now we select the SSL. Just the standard Let's Encrypt and click on get. And now we can go down to actions, click on this three dotted button and click enforce HTTPS. Click on this. And now our website should be secured. And to check this, let's go to WordPress, click on install and manage. Scroll down and click on login to admin panel. This will take you to our WordPress backend. Scroll down, click on exit, and you can see here our site has a lock on it. This means that our SSL certificate has been installed successfully and our site is secured. And last check is you can click on here and visit the website. And once again, here's our bare bones website with our lock on it. Just a quick note on my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up SiteGround through my link, just simply send me your full receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll send you the free access to my course. Now that you have successfully installed WordPress to your bare bones SiteGround hosting account, you are ready to build out your actual website. And this next video will help you do just that. So check it out and I'll see you in the next tutorial.